Subroutines, or procedures as they're known in some languages, are a really important part of modern programming languages. Essentially what they do is allow us to take bits of code that we've already written and group them together and pull them away into like a little sub-program of their own. So in this example we have a little section of code that simply prints out some X's. But you can imagine this could be a very complex piece of code doing something like printing out all of the factors of a number. What we can do is we can take that code and we can create what's called a subroutine using the keyword sub. We then need to give our subroutine a name, and we then put the code that all belongs to that subroutine in between the sub and the end sub commands. Obviously now to call this code we're going to have some code within our main routine or even within other subroutines. Simply all we do is we say print x, open and close brackets. What that will do is it will jump into our subroutine, complete the instructions, and then return back to where it was called from. So if we wanted to do the same thing again, we just have print x once again, and that would now do the call the subroutine twice. The big benefit of this is how much it simplifies our programs and gives them a much better structure. As our programs get larger, they can often get difficult to handle. However, if we have subroutines, we can use them just once and then call them lots and lots of different times. Also, we can fix bugs a lot easier because all of the code's contained in one place and we fix it once rather than in lots of copies. We can also make subroutines smarter by passing in parameters. So for example, for our printing x subroutine we've written, imagine we wanted to specify a different number of x's that we're going to print on the screen. All we have to do is in the definition of the printx subroutine is we can pass in one or more variables. In this case, we're going to create an integer called n, and then we're going to use that variable within our subroutine. So as you can see here, what that's done is when we call print n with a number, it gets passed into the subroutine and then that number gets used. And we can do that for multiple things. So in this case here, you can see now, if we change that number, rerun our code, the subroutine gets called twice, but two different parameters get passed to them, and therefore in this case we get a different number of x printed out.